We are joined by Coach Mullen here in studio. Pleasure to have you. Coach, year two, but the schedule doesn't do you any favors. You have to go at LSU, at Alabama, at Florida. That's the last four national champs. A bunch of people back on both sides of the ball. How far away is Mississippi State?
You know, we're building our program. The great thing we had in year one was our players bought into what we're trying to do. And winning the last game of the season, we had a big victory over our rival. And I think that catapulted us into the offseason. Where we feel we have a chance to be competitive in the SEC West and have a chance to try to get to Atlanta this year. We're still a very young team. And so, I mean, is this our year that we're full of seniors and this is our big season? I don't think so. Because we are young, but I think we have a great future ahead of us in the program in the next couple of years.
That SEC is a snake pit. There's everybody around you. Now, everybody sells. You come here, we have tradition, we'll work hard, we'll do these things. What can you sell that not everybody can sell?
Hey, really, there's two things that we look at. One, they have the opportunity to build a tradition at Mississippi State. They don't get to be the next Tim Tebow, the next Peyton Manning. They get to be the guy, number one, when they come play for us. But also, there's a lot of talent in the state of Mississippi, a lot of high school talent. And we're trying to give those guys, and you know, if you count to Memphis and Alabama, Louisiana, a place where they can play close to home, have a chance to win a championship without having to travel, and their family gets to see them every week. And that's for us. If we can control recruiting within our state and within our local areas, we'll have a chance to build a championship program.
Coach, you talk about recruiting quarterbacks, and a little bit was made last week of Nick Saban coming out and saying that the spread offense hasn't developed quarterbacks for the next level. Now, I want to go a little step further. Tell us, what is it about your offense that prepares quarterbacks to play in the NFL?
You know, I think we put an awful lot on them. You know, now maybe the system that we're running shouldn't be a little bit different than what they run in the NFL. But the responsibilities as far as coverage recognition, protection checks, how complicated we get within those things, that I think the mental jump to the next level is not a huge one for our quarterbacks once they've played in spread offense.
Now, Tim Tebow, one of the quarterbacks who you've developed, he's with Denver now, drafted in the first round. You know a little something about being a quarterback in Denver. How will he fare at the NFL level?
I think Tim's going to do fine. And, you know, I think just as Brian did fine. I mean, the number one trait to me that you want to look for in a quarterback is a winner. You know, a lot of different guys throw the ball differently. Some run, some, you know, are not great runners. Some are great in the pocket. Some are average in the pocket. But all great quarterbacks win. And that, to me, is what Tim Tebow has. Like a lot of other quarterbacks, that won national championships.
You compare me to Tim Tebow? Is that what you're doing?
That's what it is.
I think he just did. I heard that. He just did that. Now, there may be some extra motivation in one of your games, and that's when you play Alabama. Not only did they get you pretty good last year, but on their tickets this year when they printed up against Mississippi State, they didn't even spell the school name right. They couldn't spell Mississippi right. What do you make of that?
You know, I think in first grade they teach you how to spell Mississippi. Like most little kids, like that's one of the first things you learn how to spell. So, you know, I don't know. I mean, I'm sure it's just a glitch over there in the state of Alabama education system.
Very good political answer from the man from New Hampshire.
How's this? When you give the pregame speech, will that make its way into it before you take the field?
You know what? I don't think. We're going to have, when we're playing Alabama, you have to go to play the defending national champions. There's going to be a lot more things for us to worry about than whether or not they're spelling our name right.